We're here at City Hall for Idaho Day, the International Day Against Homophobia and Transphobia. The City of Greater Geelong are very happy to fly the rainbow flag in support of all our members of the Geelong community. We're joined with Inspector Graham Banks from the Geelong Police. Now, it's an important day here at City Hall. Can you tell us what the involvement is with the Geelong Police Force?
Okay. Well, we're here to represent, I suppose, all the officers in Geelong and the greater Geelong region. What we now have in Geelong is three gay and lesbian liaison officers, and they're there to engage with both the community, but also internally with gay and lesbian members of our staff. So we're here to support them and also the broader gay and lesbian community and transgender community. I think a number of the people who've spoken here today have spoken very eloquently about that. We've come a long way in the community and in policing, I think, as well, but we still have a long way to go. And while we need to go, we'll still support.
Lovely to see all the force here today too.
It is. No, look, everyone wanted to come, so it was no one's rostered to attend. Some have come in their own time, some of people are on leave, and other members have just taken 5 minutes away from the desk to come and show their support. So, no, it's great.
Thanks for your time.
No worries. Thank you.
We're joined with Ainsley Mason, the MC here today at City Hall, an activist with GASP. First of all, Ainsley, can you tell us, people that don't know what GASP is, can you tell us what it's all about?
Yeah, of course. So GASP is a local group that originally started out just to support young people who are coming out or gender diverse or even questioning in the city. And then eventually, as some of the kids started to get a little bit more confident and comfortable with who they were, it sort of naturally progressed on to some sort of activism roles, so which includes stuff today like raising the rainbow flag. We've also done things like participated in pride marches, spoken to the local councillors, and just basically anything that we can do to just help out and get kids involved with, you know, the culture and everything like that too. Yeah.
So what sort of time period has GASP been running?
They celebrated their 18th birthday last year. Yeah, so nearly 20 years, yeah.
Fantastic. So have you seen much change over that period of time that you've been involved anyway?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, the group just keeps getting bigger and bigger, and we get more and more support like every year, which is fantastic. It really goes to show that all our hard work's paying off, and we're getting the word out there for everybody. Yeah, yeah.
And the crowd here today is a comfort to you as well, I'm sure.
Yeah, absolutely. It makes me really, really happy to see so many people supporting us. Yeah.
I hope you're able to have a good week. There's events basically all week this week?
Yeah. Like not only in Geelong, around the world for International Day Against Homophobia and Transphobia. It's really exciting.
And we're joined with Councillor Jan Farrell and also Cameron Hampson and Michaela Carr here at City Hall to celebrate a fantastic week of events. Can you tell us a bit about it, Jan?
So today we raised the rainbow flag on City Hall. This is the second time that we've had this, but the difference this year has been that the whole event has been organised by young people.
All right. So first of all, tell us what the day is.
It's Idaho Day, International Day Against Homophobia and Transphobia.
And biphobia,
sorry.
And intersexphobia.
They keep adding letters. I'll keep up.
It's always changing. Well,
you got to include everyone.
All right. So the aim of raising the flag here at City Hall, and what's the message being given out to the City of Greater Geelong?
So the City of Greater Geelong is proud to support our LGBTIQ, particularly young people, through the GAS project. And so this is a very visual and obvious way to show that support. And the flag will fly here until we need the flagpole for another event.
All right, so GAS has been going for about 18 years, but the action team, Cameron, can you tell us a bit about that?
The action team started up recently, and basically it's sort of for young people who want to become a bit more sort of politically active. So we work together do awareness raising, different activities, and we organise the event today.
Tell us about your involvement with GASP.
Okay, so I first went along to GASP to support my little sibling, and then as I mentioned in my speech, I have an aunt who is gay. I also have an uncle who is gay, and so growing up around that, I was kind of like the norms, and I thought, why isn't this, you know, more out there and things like that, but it isn't. And so the standout group was kind of like a way of me being able to like put my foot forward to progress into the Greater Geelong of how, you know, this is normal and everything, I think. Yeah. And so it's like we just organise our events and awareness, and we become politically active, and, you know, I think 10 to 25, yeah, that you're able to join GASP. And so it's great for the youth.
So, Cameron, if people are interested in getting involved with GASP, how could they find out more?
GASP has a website, which you can easily just Google GASP and it'll come up. You can also, it sort of has all the contact details, phone number. It's at the city of Greater Geelong, like the old post office, so it's fairly easy to get in touch if you need to.
And I'd imagine that you'd be very welcoming to anybody who'd want to be involved.
Absolutely. When I first sort of entered GASP 2 years ago, I sort of immediately felt comfortable and I felt at home, so it's a wonderful space.
Right. Well, I hope you're able to enjoy the activities of the week. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
From the City of Greater Geelong, City Hall, Merrill Friend, News Geelong.